Hello, my dear students. I welcome you for another online class. I, Yangchun Longmu Lepcha, am here to give you a critical analysis of Shall I Compare Thee to a Summer's Day, written by William Shakespeare. Before I start my lesson, let me repeat the drill. Reading of the textbook is mandatory. If you haven't read the poem, please kindly read the poem and then watch the video. Or while watching the video, if you keep the book open, it would be better for you all. Next, while continuing with my seminar or my presentation, I would be speaking in Nepali language in between for your convenience and to enhance your understanding. Now, moving on to my topic. So, firstly, I'll talk about the author or the poet William Shakespeare. Then I'll boil down my topic into sonnet. I will explain the origin of sonnet, categories of sonnet, and the features of sonnet. Then I will plunge into my main topic, that is a critical analysis of Shall I Compare Thee to a Summer's Day. Then after that, I will give you some sample questions, and in that way. And I've also mentioned the summary link, which you can take it, download the PDF, and use it for your future reference. Now moving on to the author or the poet, William Shakespeare. Now English literature is incomplete without the study of this person or his works, and this person is none other than William Shakespeare. He was an English dramatist, poet, a humanist. The speciality of Shakespeare is that he studied, observed human beings. He meticulously and clearly portrayed the emotions, the social nature of human being. Therefore, he was so famous in all his works, and all the people around him was flabbergasted to see how well William Shakespeare has portrayed the emotions and the variety and the dynamic nature of human being. Indeed, he is the discovery of not only England but the world. He was an amazing actor as well, and therefore he was regarded as, you know, the national poet of England on account of his skill and meticulous skill in his works. And he was also entitled as a Bard of Avon. Bard meaning poet, and Avon is the place in England where he was born. He wrote around 39 plays, 154 sonnets, and 2 long narrative poems. I've mentioned some of his plays, and plays are Hamlet, As You Like It, Macbeth, Tempest. And out of 154 sonnets, I've mentioned 2 sonnets. They are Shall I Compare Thee, which we are learning right now, and next is Look in Thy Glass. The 2 long narrative poems are Venus and Adonis and The Rape of Lucrece. Ben Jonson, another important contemporary fellow being of William Shakespeare, said that William Shakespeare, he was not of an age, but for all time. Indeed, this is apparently and evidently true. The statement is true because we are still now, not only in 16th century, but till now we are reading William Shakespeare, reading about William Shakespeare, reading his works, and the future generations will continue to read. So in this way, you can estimate the work and depth of William Shakespeare. Now moving on to the next. Now let me explain you what is a sonnet. Okay, now sonnet is a 14-line poem. It is derived from the Italian word sonetto, meaning a little song or a little small lyric. It was originated in Italy, and when it was originated in Italy, it was Petrarch, another Italian writer, Petrarch, who flourished it in Italy, and from there it was Thomas Watt and Earl of Surrey, 2 important English writers. They got this technique from Italy to England and therefore flourished in England. Okay, and later it was William Shakespeare who mastered this skill of writing sonnet, of writing this 14-line poem. Now, what are the important features or the main features of sonnet? Right, the first is rhyme scheme, the second is structure meaning bhag, okay, organization of 14 line poem. The next is pattern of the line or lines or rhythm. Pattern in which way it is, the which the line is portrayed, that gives rhythm to the poem. Lai dinsa. Okay. Now what is a rhyme scheme? Rhyme scheme is the pattern of rhymes at the end of each line of a poem. Can you see at the end of each line? I have put it in bold letters. Day. The first line ends with day, and that day matches with the third line, May. So in that way, you can, you know, get a rhythm or a rhyme. Day, May. Whereas the second line, that is temperate, matches with the fourth line, that is date. So in that way, what happens? You get melody. Euta lai pauncha euta kavita ma, and tesai karan le ke garcha, surilo banauncha, and that is called rhyme scheme. Okay. Now categories of sonnet. So depending on the rhyme scheme, the structure, that the structure means organization or bhag, right? And pattern, we have three categories of sonnet. Okay. The first category is Italian or Petrarchan sonnet. As I already mentioned you before that in Italy, it was an Italian writer who, Petrarch, who flourished this technique of 14 line poem. And therefore, in order to tribute him, they called that sonnet as Petrarchan sonnet. And rhyme scheme of this sonnet is ABBA, ABBA, CDE, CDE. यो 14 लाइन पोयमलाई चाहिँ नि यस्तो प्रकारको राइम स्किममा चाहिँ प्रस्तुत गरिएको छ. अल्टरनेटिभली द राइटर्स अल्सो समटाइम्स चुज टु राइट द लास्ट 6 लाइन्स अफ द पोयम विथ सिटिसी ओर सिडिसी. इन द्याट वे यो राइम स्किमले चाहिँ के गर्छ भन्दाखेरि चाहिँ के गर्छ, लय दिन्छ, मेलोडी दिन्छ. ओके, मुभिङ अन टु द नेक्स्ट सोनेट, द्याट इज द इङ्ग्लिस ओर शेक्सपियरियन सोनेट. As I told you, it was Thomas Watt and the Earl of Surrey who got this technique from Italy to England. And later on, it was William Shakespeare who mastered this technique of writing sonnet. Therefore, he wrote 154 sonnets. Okay, William Shakespeare mastered this technique and therefore wrote 154 sonnets. And in order to tribute William Shakespeare, they termed this sonnet as Shakespearean sonnet. And the rhyme scheme of this sonnet is AB, AB, CD, CD, EF, EF, GG. This is very important for you all to remember as we are doing what, which sonnet? Shakespearean sonnet. Okay. Next one is Spenserian sonnet. Okay, another important writer in England was Edmund Spenser. And Edmund Spenser used another technique. Okay, use the same technique but in a different way. The rhyme scheme is slightly different from that of Shakespearean sonnet. So therefore, in order to tribute or honor Edmund Spenser, they termed it as, you know, a Spenserian sonnet. And the rhyme scheme of this sonnet is AB, AB, BC, BC, CD, CD, EE. Now I have mentioned these three categories just for your understanding, but you all have to focus mainly on English or the Shakespearean sonnet. Okay, next. Now let us focus and boil down our topic to the Shakespearean sonnet. What is this Shakespearean sonnet and why is it famous for? It is very easy to write 14 line poem, right? Not very easy, but most of the people tend to write 14 line poem. But what is the speciality of sonnet? I told you right before, it is the rhyme scheme, the organization or structure, and the pattern in which they write that makes the sonnet special. Now we are going to study these three aspects line by line. Okay, Shakespearean sonnet. It is always written in iambic pentameter. What is the pattern? It is iambic pentameter. In my next slide or next to next slide, I am going to talk about iambic pentameter in detail. Specific rhyme scheme, I have already mentioned, right? Rhyme scheme, lai dinsa. What is the rhyme scheme of this Shakespearean sonnet? It is AB, AB, CD, CD, EF, EF, GG. Very important, you all have to mark it, okay? structure. Now let us come to the structure of this Shakespearean sonnet, which is prescribed for you all in your syllabus. Structure कुछ तो प्रकार ले लिख दे रहे सर ये 14 लाइन पोएम्स है ये 14 लाइन पोएम्स लाए तेतिके लिख देना नहीं 14 लाइन में तेतिके लिख देना नहीं उन अरे भाग एउटा डिविजन में लिखे कुछ था अनि पोएट्री में जब तिमी ले डिविजन बनाओ सर तेला के बन सा स्टैंजा बनें सा जब तिमी नॉवल में एउटा भाग छुट्टा हुन्छ तेला के बन सा पैराग्राफ बनें सा कोई बेला हमी क्वाट्रन पनि भन्छ इन पोएट्री ओके नाउ इन स्ट्रक्चर अब शेक्सपियरियन सोनेट को स्ट्रक्चर चाहिँ कस्तो रहेछ भन्दाले थ्री क्वाट्रन्स एन्ड अ कन्क्लुडिङ कपलेट इफ यु गो एन्ड सी द पेज अफ शाल आई कम्पेयर दी अफ दिस 18 सोनेट 18 यु विल सी द्याट इट इज डिभाइडेड इन्टु थ्री क्वाट्रन्स चारटा चारटा चारटाको एउटा क्वाट्रन्स छ तिनवटा क्वाट्रन्स छ अनि लास्टमा एन्डमा चाहिँ दुईवटा लाइन छ त्यसलाई चाहिँ भन्छ कपलेट ओके What is quatrain? Quatrain is a stanza containing four lines. Okay, and couplet ke resa? Couplet is a pair of successive lines of poem, typically rhyming and of the same length. To timi jab end ma hersau, tya dui ta line dekho chhau. Okay, if you go and see the end of the letter or the word of the end of those two lines, you will see that there is a rhyme. Like for example, out there here where it's C and D, it rhymes with one another, you know. And yo duita line ko che ke sa timro duita length pani equal sa. So yo duita line ma jab timro length equal sa ani rhyme pani euta sa telai che ke ban sa rhyme couplet ban sa. Whereas agi ko ma rhyme ma che ke thyo timro alternate line ma rhyme scheme mileko thyo. A सीसँग मिलेको थियो अनि बी डीसँग मिलेको थियो तर यहाँ चाहिँ के हुँदैछ ए र ए सँगै मिल्दैछ ओके वाट इज द मेन इम्पोर्टेन्ट फ्याक्टर यु हेभ टु रिमेम्बर हियर इन दिस कपलेट इज यसको लाइन एउटा लेन्थ एउटै हुन्छ अनि एट द एन्ड यसको राइम एउटै हुन्छ देन नेक्स्ट इज इच लाइन हेज 10 सिलेबल्स आई विल टक अबाउट सिलेबल्स इन माई नेक्स्ट स्लाइड एन्ड इन्क्लुड्स वल्टा हेरै शेक्सपियरियन सोनेटमा एउटा फ्याक्टर हुन्छ वल्टा भन्ने वल्टा भनेको केही पनि होइन बट इट इज सडन टर्न राइटरले अगाडिको लाइनमा अगाडिको लाइन्समा उसको कथा उसको इमोसन्स भन्दै जान्छ बट इन बिचमा आएर चाहिँ देयर सडनली अ ट्विस्ट इन द टेल ओर लाइक सडनली देयर इज अ टर्न स्पेसिफिक टर्न अनि त्यो टर्नलाई चाहिँ के भन्छ वल्टा भनिन्छ अनि त्यो वल्टा चाहिँ केले मार्क गर्छ बट But le mark karsa. Okay, there is a transition in the emotion of the writer when he mentions but, and from there you will see another rise of another emotion. Okay, next. Now syllable. What is a syllable? As I told you before, there is 10 syllables in every line of sonnet. Now what is syllable? A syllable is a unit of pronunciation having one vowel sound with or without consonant sounds. भनेको चाहिँ अब तिमीले जब एउटा साउन्ड प्रड्युस गर्छौ नि त्यसलाई चाहिँ के गर्नु साउन्ड प्रड्युस गर्दाखेरि यु हेभ टु इन्क्लुड अ वावल साउन्ड भन्दैछ यहाँनिर लाइक फर इक्जाम्पल एइआइओयु के हो वावल्स एन्ड रेस्ट आर कन्सनेन्ट साउन्ड्स अब तिमीले एउटा साउन्ड प्रड्युस गर कन्सनेन्ट साउन्ड्स खालि हालेर लाइक फर इक्जाम्पल बिजी छ आर यु एबल टु प्रड्युस अ साउन्ड विथ बिजी ब एन्ड ग ब ब खालि हुँदैछ सो साउन्डै प्रड्युस भएको छैन यहाँनिर राइट वेयर एज इफ यु इन्क्लुड वान वावल साउन्ड हियर द्याट इज बिएजी ब्याग देन यु आर एबल टु प्रड्युस अ साउन्ड ब्याग भन्न सकिन्छ ओके होइन So what is this? So yeah, similarly dog, D-O-G, dog, hamile pronounce garda kiri, sound produce garna sakdaicha. Now D-G lai khali timile pronounce garna sakchau, sound produce garna sakchau, d, sakdaina ni ta haina. So what is this syllable? Syllable is the smallest unit of sound. Sound ko sabse banda smallest unit lai chai ke bancha, timro syllable bancha. Ani yo sound ma chai chai le pani ke प्रेजेंट हुन्छ वावल साउंड इंग्लिश में कन्सोनेंट साउंड ले खाली साउंड प्रोड्यूस गर्नु सक्दैन त्यसमा तिम्रो के हुन्छ वावल साउंड चाहिँ प्रेजेंट हुन्छै हुन्छ ओके एंड लाइक फर एक्जापल अई बवल ने तिम्रो सिलेबल्स तिमी छुट्टन सक साउंड तिमी सानो भाग यूनिट में क्रिएट कर सौ डिवाइड कर सर तेस में कुछ साउंड प्रेजेंट होने पर्च दैट इज बवल साउंड लाइक फर एक्जापल स्नैप कतिवटा बवल छ यहाँ एवटा एसएनपी के हो एसएनपी कन्सोनेंट साउंड हो एसएनपी बट तिमी साउंड प्रड्यूस कर सौ स्नैप स्नप हुन्छ बट इफ यू इन्क्लूड वन बवल साउंड ए अ व्हाट हैपन्स स्नैप भयो कि भएन सो इन दिस वे दिस इज अ मोनोसिलेबिक वर्ड भनेको यहाँ एउटा सिलेबल छ यो वर्ड में कतिवटा सिलेबल छ एउटा स्मलेस्ट यूनिट यसलाई तिमीले दुईटा में डिवाइड गर्न सक्दैन है नेक्स्ट दुईटा सिलेबल भएको वर्ड टू सिलेबिक वर्ड दैट इज डाइसिलेबिक वर्ड बास्केट बास्केट लाई डिवाइड गर भन्यो भने कसरी गर्छौ बास्केट राइट सो यहाँ नि के हुन्छ बास्केट बास मा कति वटा बबल छ एउटा अ केट मा कति वटा बबल छ एउटा ए सो बास्केट यसले गर्दा खेरि साउन्ड प्रोड्यूस भयो कि भएन यसले गर्दा सिलेबल पनि तिमीले डिवाइड गर्न सक्यौ कि सकेनौ अनि यहाँ कति वटा सिलेबल छ भने तिमी कति वटा भन्छ दुईटा छ किनभने यु आर एबल टु डिवाइड दिस वर्ड इन्टू टू क्याटेगोरीज सो त्यसलाई के भन्दै रहेछ डाइसिलेबिक वर्ड नेक्स्ट तीनटा सिलेबल भएको वर्डहरू पनि हुन्छ लाइक एडवान्टेज एडी अड एउटा एले सिलेबल वान एउटा सिलेबल टेज एउटा सिलेबल ट्राइसिलेबिक वर्ड थर्ड चारटा सिलेबल भएको वर्ड छ यहाँ चाहिँ एक्जामिनेसन क्वाड्रिक सिलेबिक वर्ड यहाँ चाहिँ चारटा तिम्रो सिलेबल छ मैले यो किन भनेको वाई एम आई एम्फसाइजिङ अन सिलेबल्स भन्दाखेरि पोएट्रीमा पढ्दाखेरि एउटा लिरिकल इफेक्ट आउँछ सोनेटमा एउटा के म्युजिकल इफेक्ट हुन्छ त्यसको लागि तिमीले के याद गर्नुपर्छ साउन्ड साउन्डलाई कसरी पोएटहरूले डिभाइड गर्दै रहेछ स्मलेस्ट युनिटमा डिभाइड गर्छ अनि त्यो स्मलेस्ट युनिटलाई के भन्छ फर्स्ट थिङ सिलेबल भन्छ सिलेबल चाहिँ तिमीले चाहिँ कसरी पाउँदो रहेछ भन्दाखेरि चाहिँ यहाँ आउँदो रहेछ नि त अन्त योमा चाहिँ जहिले पनि के हुँदो रहेछ यो सिलेबलमा चाहिँ वावल साउन्ड प्रेजेन्ट हुँदो रहेछ साउन्ड प्रड्युस गर्नुको लागि नै हामीलाई के चाहिन्छ हामीलाई वावल साउन्ड चाहिन्छ कन्सोनेन्ट साउन्डले कुनै साउन्ड पनि हामीले के गर्न सक्दैन प्रड्युस गर्न सक्दैन ओके नाउ सिलेबल अफ द शेक्सपियरियन सोनेट ओके अघिको फिचरमा के थियो भन्नाले We have each line has 10 syllables. Okay, again we got to know about monosyllabic, one syllabic, two syllabic word, three syllabic word, four syllabic word. And in your sonnet, there are 10 syllables. 10 smallest unit of sound present in this sonnet. Okay, let's see. And I've given the example of the first line. अब शाल आई कम्पेयर दी टु अ समर्स डे यसलाई डिभाइड गर कुन चाहिँ कति कसरी डिभाइड गर्न सक्छु शाल एउटा बबल छ है भनेपछि मोनोसिलेबिक वर्ड आई इज मोनोसिलेबिक वर्ड आई बबल छ कम्पेयर कम्पेयरलाई दुईवटा भागमा हामीले के गर्न सक्छ डिभाइड गर्न सक्छ सो डाइसिलेबिक वर्ड दुईवटा भयो दी एउटा वावल सो वट इट बिकम्स मोनो मोनोसिलेबिक टू वावल याद गर कि इच एन्ड एभ्री सिलेबलमा के छ वावल साउन्ड छ सो त्यही कारणले हामीलाई के सजिलो हुँदैछ काट्नु डिभाइड गर्न सजिलो हुँदैछ एट द सेम टाइम साउन्ड प्रड्युस गर्न सजिलो भइरहेको छ अनि शेक्सपियरियन सोनेटमा चाहिँ जहिले पनि तिम्रो कतिवटा सिलेबल हुन्छ अरे एभ्री लाइनमा 10 सिलेबल हुन्छ अरे सेकेन्ड राउन्ड पनि काउन्ट गर थर्ड लाइन फोर्थ लाइन लास्ट लाइन नै काउन्ट किन नगर कतिवटा सिलेबल हुन्छ अरे 10 यो 10 ओके नेक्स्ट नाउ वाट इज आइएम्बिक पेन्टामिटर शेक्सपियरियन सोनेट कस्तो प्याटर्नमा लेखिन्छ भनेर क्वेसन आयो भने तिमी के भन्छौ इट इज रिटन इन आइएम्बिक पेन्टामिटर नाउ वाट इज आइएम्बिक पेन्टामिटर ओके आइएम्बिक भन्नाले के बुझिन्छ इट इज अ प्याटर्न लाइक फर एक्जाम्पल अ प्याटर्न वेयर एन अनस्ट्रेस सिलेबल इज फलोड बाई अ स्ट्रेस सिलेबल Before I explain this, I will give you one slight example. Abo school ma, when we recited Twinkle Twinkle Little Star, how did we recite it? We recited with one rhythm, with one, you know, tune, right? Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are. The bandhina nita. We study it as twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are. So can you see the rhythm here? Can you see the like stress part, unstressed part? Can you see this line? यो गरे भने के हुन्छ लाइफ हुन्छ क्यान हेभ यु सिन यो यो हस्पिटलमा बिमार हुँदा हाम्रो हार्टबिट काउन्ट गर्दाखेरि के हुन्छ इसिजीतिर हेभ यु सिन द्याट स्ट्रक्चर द्याट फ्ल्यासेस अन द स्क्रिन अगाडि माथि तल माथि तल माथि तल एन्ड सपोज इफ यु आर डेड इफ द पर्सन इज डेड कस्तो खालको लाइन हुन्छ एउटा मोनोटोनस स्ट्रेट लाइन आउँछ सिमिलरली पोएममा पनि एउटा इन्ग्रिडियन्ट एउटा लाइफ पाउनुको लागि के चाहिन्छ तिमीलाई एउटा ट्युन चाहिन्छ एउटा रिदम चाहिन्छ एउटा प्याटर्न चाहिन्छ यु क्यान नट जस्ट स्ट्रेट अवे रिड ट्विङ्कल ट्विङ्कल लिटल स्टार हाउ आर वन्डर वाट यु आर अर यु क्यान नट जस्ट स्ट्रिट स्याल आई कम्पेयर दि टु इट इट साउन्ड सो ओड देयर ह्याज टु बी अ रिदम देयर ह्याज टु बी अ ट्युन घरमा पनि बोल्दाखेरि पनि मलाई यो चाहियो मलाई यो गर्यो यु क्यान नट गो मोनोटोनसली राइट इट बिकम्स सो प्लेन You have to add life to it. So in order to add life to the poem, authors and poets add pattern. Euta pattern form garcha. Ani tesei euta pattern chai ke ho timro? Iambic pentameter. Iambic pentameter chai kasto khalke pattern rhecha bhandakheri chai. Agadiko it is followed by two syllables. Okay, two syllables. Syllable bhaneko shortest, kyo? Smallest unit of sound. It is followed where unstressed syllable is followed by stressed syllable. अगाडिको हामीले सिलेबललाई चाहिँ स्ट्रेस गर्दैन रहेछ एन्ड ब्याकको सिलेबललाई चाहिँ हामीले के गर्दो रहेछ आयम्बिक पेन्टामिटामा स्ट्रेस गरेर भन्दो रहेछ हामीले कतिवटा कुरा भन्दाखेरि के गर्छ स्ट्रेस गरेर भन्छ नि कतिवटा अनइम्पोर्टेन्ट कुरा स्ट्रेस गर्दैन त्यसरी नै पोएममा पनि कतिवटा कुरालाई तिमीले स्ट्रेस गर्नुपर्छ कतिवटा कुरा स्ट्रेस गर्न पर्दैन अनि सिमिलरली आयम्बिक प्याटर्न चाहिँ यस्तो प्याटर्न रहेछ जहाँ चाहिँ अगाडिपट्टि तिमीले यो अगाडिपट्टि देयर इज अ सिम्बल अल्सो सिम्बल अफ आयम्बिक पेन्टर इज यु एन्ड अपटर्न्ड वी अर उल्टा वी ओके सो यु मिन्स द्याट यु सुड नट स्ट्रेस इट इज फर मार्क्ड बाई अनस्ट्रेस सिलेबल युमा चाहिँ तिमीले स्ट्रेस गर्न परेन Whereas in V or upturned V, ma chai timile ke garnu parcha alikati alikati stress garnu parcha. And the example of this pattern word or iambic word is destroy. Abe right? Destroy first euta word ho. Yelai divide garda kati euta syllable ma huncha? Duita syllable. Euta des ho ani troy ho. Aba timile yo destroy lai kasari pronounce garchau? That is very important. Okay? तिमीले यसलाई आयम्बिक प्रकारले प्रनाउन्स गर्ने रहेछ यसलाई डेस्ट्रोय भन्दो रहेछौ तिमीले डेस्ट्रोय त भन्न सक्दैन नि त अगाडिले स्ट्रेस गर्नु भएन पछि स्ट्रेस गर्नुपर्छ अनि इक्जाम्पल डेस्ट्रोय ओके सिमिलरली अनदर इक्जाम्पल इज डिले टु सिलेबल है डिलेलाई डिभाइड गर्दा दुईवटा सिलेबल पायो अनि त्यसलाई प्याटर्न कुन चाहिँ प्याटर्न हाल्दो रहेछ आयम्बिक प्याटर्न हाल्दो रहेछ अनि त्यसलाई के भन्दो रहेछ डिले यसलाई डिले त भन्दैन त डिले भन्दैन यसलाई डिले ओके सिमिलरली डेस्क्राइब डेस्क्राइबमा अगाडिपट्टि डिस्क्राइब दिस इज रङ यु हेभ टु अटर इट प्रनाउन्स इट एज डेस्क्राइब ओके Most of the people or most of the students have this complaint ki my expression is very bad or weak or poor because sometimes we do not okay stress the correct word that's why hamro ke huncha expression alikati tema clarity hudaina now how will you read this poem that is very important ab yo pattern ma haleko cha ni to william shakespeare le You cannot read, shall I compare thee to a summer's day? You cannot reply, or you cannot study as, shall I compare thee to a summer's day? No. Punctuation mark is another important signal for you all to read correctly. Then the pattern is another important signal for you all to read correctly. Like for example, yaha maile dekho chu timile pattern, iambic ko pattern. Shall, yo upturned V ma alikati stress garnu parcha. I bhanera author le afulai sodhdaicha. Shall I compare, pair ma stress gardaicha, thee to a summer's day. Day ma tala question sodhdaicha ni ta. So read gardakheri timile tyo yaad garnu parcha. Annana dhunama read garera hudaina. okay? Next line is like, thou art more lovely and more temperate. So, यसरी तिमीले अब अहिले त मैले तिमीहरूले एक्सप्लेन गर्दै गर्दै गर्दाखेरि आधा आधा रिड गर्दैछु. बट इफ यु रिड अकर्डिङ टु द प्याटर्न, यु विल गेट वाट मेलोडी साउन्ड लिरिक. ओके, सो यो प्र्याक्टिस गर्नुपर्छ अनि यो प्रकारले चाहिँ रिडिङ गर्नुपर्छ. यसरी चाहिँ तिम्रो के इम्प्रुभ हुन्छ भन्दाखेरि चाहिँ रिडिङ ह्याबिट इम्प्रुभ हुन्छ, तिम्रो रिडिङ स्किल डेभलप हुन्छ. इङ्ग्लिस इज नट जस्ट अबाउट यु नो रिडिङ, यु आर लिसनिङ टु द स्टोरिज एन्ड राइटिङ स्टोरिज. यु हेभ टु इम्प्रुभ युर रिडिङ स्किल्स एट द सेम टाइम. सो यसरी नै राइटर्सहरूले चाहिँ तिम्रो रिडिङ स्किल इम्प्रुभ होस् अर मेलोडी पावर्स एउटा वर्कले भनेर चाहिँ प्याटर्न फलो गर्छ. अनि सनेटले चाहिँ कुन चाहिँ प्याटर्न फलो गर्दै रहेछ शेक्सपियरियन सोनेटले, आयम्बिक पेन्टामिटर. अनि आयम्बिक पेन्टामिटरमा आयम्बिक चाहिँ तिमीले के बुझौ, एउटा प्याटर्न रहेछ. अनि कस्तो खालको प्याटर्न रहेछ यसमा चाहिँ, योमा चाहिँ यु र उल्टा वी अपटर्न वी रहेछ. अनि त्यो यु भनेको चाहिँ के भन्दो रहेछ, अनस्ट्रेस, बेसी स्ट्रेस गर्दैन है, इम्पोर्टेन्ट त्यति साह्रो इम्पोर्टेन्ट छैन. अनि स्ट्रेस चाहिँ के हो, तिमीले त्यहाँनिर एम्फोसाइज गरेर बताउनको लागि चाहिँ तिमीले के गर्छौ, त्यो अपटर्न वी युज गर्छौ. एन्ड द वाट इज द सिम्बल, सिम्बल इज यु एन्ड अपटर्न वी. ओके, नेक्स्ट. नाउ वाट इज पेन्टामिटर? अब आइएम्पिक त भन्यो है, अब पेन्टामिटर चाहिँ के रहेछ? पेन्टा इन ग्रिक मिन्स फाइभ, राइट? मिटर, अघि प्याटर्न बुझ्यो है, अघि प्याटर्न बुझ्यो. एन्ड यहाँ यहाँ शालाई कम्पेयर दिमा यो प्याटर्न के भएको छ, रिपिट भएको छ. सो रिकरेन्स अफ अ प्रमिनेन्ट प्याटर्न इन सिक्वेन्स अफ स्पिच साउन्ड्स अफ अ ल्याङ्ग्वेज. जब यो प्याटर्न पोएट्रीमा रिपिट हुन्छ नि, त्यसलाई कुन चाहिँ टर्म भन्दो रहेछ, त्यसलाई मिटर भन्दो रहेछ. ओके, सो द रिपिटेसन अफ अ प्याटर्न इन द पोएट्री इज नोन एज वाट, मिटर. ओके, एन्ड वाट इज पेन्टेन देन? जब यो प्याटर्न, जब यो प्याटर्न छ नि आइएम्बिक प्याटर्न पाँचपल्ट एउटा लाइनमा रिपिट हुन्छ, त्यसलाई के भन्दो रहेछ, पेन्टामिटर. बुझ्यो? यहाँनिर इफ यु सी आइएम्बिकको हाम्रो सिम्बल कस्तो हो, यु र अपटर्न वी. ओके, अनि त्यो कतिपल्ट रिपिट भएको छ यहाँनिर, फाइभ टाइम्स, वान टू थ्री फोर एन्ड फाइभ, मैले यहाँ मेन्सन पनि गरेको छु. जब यो प्याटर्न पाँचपल्ट रिपिट हुन्छ, त्यसलाई चाहिँ के भन्दो रहेछ, पेन्टामिटर. अनि मिटर चाहिँ के भयो भन्दाखेरि चाहिँ, जब यो रिपिट हुन्छ नि प्याटर्न, यो पोइट्रीमा चाहिँ नि यो प्याटर्न रिपिट भएकोलाई चाहिँ के भन्दो रहेछ, मिटर भन्दो रहेछ. अन्द दिस वे यु नो यु गेट टु नो वाट इज आइएम्बिक पेन्टामिटर. ओके, नेक्स्ट. Now moving on to the main analysis, okay, analysis of shall I compare thee to a summer's day. Why did I mention you about all the rhythm and pattern? Because it gives you a melody, that's why sonnet is extraordinary. But now let me talk you about the main essence or the main ingredient of this sonnet. Now here, or before I start, let me read once. Shall I compare thee to a summer's day? Thou art more lovely and more temperate. Rough winds do shake the darling buds of May, and summer's lease hath all too short a date. Now here the poet, okay, poet is trying to talk about the beauty of his beloved, and he is confused whether he should compare his beloved's beauty to that of summer. Okay, so the first word marks confusion, shows like whether he should compare the beauty of his beloved to the beauty of summer or not, is what he is talking. That's why he says, shall I, that is referring to the narrator or the poet, okay, compare thee. Thee bhanale ki bujhinche, thee bhaneko you. In old English they used to use the term thee. Thee, thou, thine are the symbolic representation of a second person singular pronoun. You भन्न खोजेको. ओके, shall I compare thee or you to a summer's day भनेर चाहिँ कम्पेयर सोध्दैछ. वाइ समर्स डे? बिकज अकर्डिङ टु इङ्ग्लिस राइटर द समर सिजन इज अ मन्थ अफ चार्म, ब्युटी, इट्स लाइक रेस्प्लेन्डेन्स, रेडियन्स. ओके, घामले के सिम्बलाइज गर्छ, अति उज्यालो है, युथ. So therefore, in order to compare, you know, not also therefore, not even what you want to compare or not. He just confused whether he should compare or not. So he's giving you a question, a rhetorical question, okay? Thou art more lovely and more temperate. So the poet is trying to say that thou manalife you bujinsa, okay? He's saying that his beloved is more beautiful, is more lovely and more temperate manale, mild and calm than the scorching and the burning heat of the sun. Rough winds do shake the darling buds of May. What happens in summer season? The rough winds that, you know, they blew away all the buds and all the shoots of plants and therefore destroyed the beauty of summer season. Okay. And in the lake at the end he says, and summer's lease hath all too short a date. He says that, the poet says that summer of all the seasons, summer is the shortest season. And lease here means a contract. Here the narrator, the poet is trying to tell you that the nature has given people on earth summer season in for contract, for lease. Of all the seasons, summer season is the very shortest season. Okay, so therefore he says that the beauty of the summer is impermanent. It is not permanent, it is temporary. So he says, how can I compare you to the beauty of summer, whose like beauty is very, you know, impermanent or temporary? How can I compare you to the beauty of, you know, summer, whose burning heat actually, you know, gives uneasiness to human beings? So in this way, the author is trying to, or the poet is trying to, you know, give you the idea of the beauty of his beloved. He is trying to tell you that the beauty of his beloved is more than the beauty of summer season. So here what he is trying to highlight, the impermanence or temperance of summer season. Okay. So in the next quatrain, he says, sometime too hot the eye of heaven shines, and often in his gold complexion dimmed, and every fair from fair sometime declines by chance or nature's changing course untrimmed. So here the author says, or author has compared sun or the sun to the eye of heaven. Okay, so like if you imagine heaven, how is the place? You imagine heaven to be the most beautiful place on earth. So imagine sun is like the eye of heaven. What is an eye? An eye is the significant part of human body, isn't it? Without our eyes, we cannot see anything. So in that way, you can understand and estimate the importance or the glory of sun. Okay, in that way, you can understand the depth of the beauty of sun. And here I would like to tell you one thing also, he has pointed out the flaw. Sometimes the sun is too hot. Imagine in summer season, in scorching heat, you will be dying out there. And would you like to enjoy summer season for a long time? Definitely not. You would definitely want a cool breeze of autumn, right? So here he is trying to tell you, te bhandesa ki gham. Or the, you know, the sun is too much at times for you to handle or bear the heat of the sun. Okay, so here I would like to highlight you all that, you know, the poet has used a figure of speech called personification. Personification meaning is giving the quality of a living being to an object or non-living thing. Like for example, eye of heaven badesa. Heaven ko aankha huncha hudaina ni ta, haina? So he is giving a quality of a human being to what? To heaven. Or to the summer season, or to sun. Sunlight, yeah, author, poet, leke bandesa, timi aankha ho, heaven ko bandesa. So in that way, he's using what kind of technique or the figure of speech? Personification. I'll give you some examples. Like, if I tell you, death has come to me as a gentleman. Mrityu mero chauma euta ramro ke purush ko roopma aairaheko cha. Literally, ariyo bhane ki mrityu manche ko roopma auna sakcha सक्दैन नि त यो त जस्ट तिमीले एउटा क्रिएटिभ वेमा एउटा हामीले इमेजिन गर्न सकोस् भनेर टेक्निक युज गर्दैछ अनि यो टेक्निकलाई चाहिँ तिमी के भन्छौ पर्सनिफिकेसन भन्छौ ओके टु गिभ अ क्वालिटी अफ लिभिङ बिइङ इफ आई से टु अ नन लिभिङ बिइङ इफ आई से द क्लाउड इज डान्सिङ बादल नाच्नु सक्छ सक्दैन नि त होइन तर जस्ट टु टेल यु द इन्टेन्सिटी अफ द क्लाउड ओर द मुभमेन्ट अफ क्लाउड आई एम टेलिङ यु द्याट क्लाउड इज डान्सिङ सो इन दिस व्यू वाट एम आई डुइङ यति बेला आई एम गिभिङ द क्वालिटिज अफ ह्युमन बिइङ टु नन लिभिङ अब्जेक्ट अर नन लिभिङ थिङ ओके सिमिलरली हियर द पोएट युजेस द टेक्निक अफ पर्सनिफिकेसन वेन ही सेज आई अफ हेभेन साइन्स आई अफ हेभेन भनेको के हो सन ओके एन्ड मोर ओभर द पोएट युजेस अनदर फिगर अफ स्पिच कल्ड मेटाफर टु मेटाफर ओके हि युजेस सन एज अ मेटाफर टु कम्पेयर द ब्युटी अफ हु हिज बिलवेड What is metaphor? A metaphor is a word, okay, used to compare an object or an action to which the meaning is not literally applicable. भन्नाले के बुझिन्छ भन्दाखेरि यहाँ हामीले कसको सुन्दरता तुलना गर्दैछौँ घामसित पोएटको बिलावेटको है प्रेमिकाको सुन्दरता तुलना गरिरहेको छ अब यो लिटरली त गरेको होइन नि त लिटरली त पोएटको प्रेमिका त घाम होइन नि त उहाँको सुन्दरताको मूल्य चाहिँ हामी केसँग कम्पेयर गरिरहेको छ घामसित सूर्यसित कम्पेयर गरिरहेको छ सो यो टेक्निक जुन चाहिँ हामी युज गर्दैछ त्यसलाई चाहिँ के भनिन्छ मेटाफर भनिन्छ ओके एन्ड ओफन इन हिज गोल्ड कम्प्लेक्सन डिम्ड हिज भन्दैछ Therefore, the poet has personified sun as a man. Therefore, he has used his bandesa. And often in his gold complexion dimmed. अब सूर्य त सधैँ भरि तिम्रो यहाँ आकाशमा त हुन्छ तर अब चम्किबस्दैन नि त हो कि होइन कोही बेला बादलले पनि ढाक्छ अनि त्यही हाम्रो अथरले के भन्नु पोएटले भन्न चाहँदैछ कि कोही बेला चाहिँ सूर्य चाहिँ के हुन्छ बादलको पछि ढकेर जान्छ And every fair from fair sometime declines. Meaning, fair from fair here means every beautiful person. Hamro sundarta ke ho? Aaja chha, boli chhaina. Okay, na? It is temporary. So from every fair to fair, this beauty declines. Okay, nature ko cycle ke ho? Riti ke ho? Rivaaz ke ho? Aaja ma ramro chhu, aaja mero jiu ramro chha, skin ramro chha, tara as the age goes or as time passes, what happens? I will age. I will get wrinkles, I will grow old. And त्यो भन्दैछ अथरले के भन्दैछ ब्युटी चाहिँ कस्तो सुन्दरता चाहिँ कस्तो चिज हो अरे एक दिन नष्ट भएर जान्छ समय अनुसार के भएर जान्छ समयमा बिलेर जान्छ भनेर चाहिँ फेयर टु फेयर फ्रम फेयर एन्ड फेयर समटाइम डिक्लाइन्स हराएर जान्छ भन्दैछ बाई चान्स ओर नेचर चेन्जिङ कोर्स अनट्रिम्ड बाई चान्स ओर नेचर्स कोर्स कोर्स अनट्रिम्ड भन्नाले के बुझिन्छ भन्दाखेरि चाहिँ नि नेचर चाहिँ यस्तो रहेछ अरे कि जसले चाहिँ कसैलाई डिस्क्रिमिनेट भिन्नता नदेखाइकन आफ्नो ल आफ्नो रीति चाहिँ उसले गर्छ मतलब यु नो द ल हामीले फलो गर्नुपर्छ लाइक फर इक्जाम्पल यो राम्रो छ यसले मलाई राम्रो गरेको छ म यसलाई बुढो बनाउँदिनँ यो नराम्रो छ म यसलाई छिट्टो बुढो बनाउँछु भनेर अब नेचरले चाहिँ के गर्छ प्रकृतिले कहिले पनि त्यस्तो सोच्दैन नि द इज अलवेज इक्विनामिटी इक्वली सबैलाई के गर्छ उसले आफ्नो ल दिन्छ अनि हामीले त्यो फलो गर्नुपर्छ सो एक न एक दिन हामी सबै के भएर जानुपर्छ बुढो भएर जानुपर्छ एन्ड द्याट इज वाट इज कल्ड कोर्स अनट्रिम्ड भनेको विदाउट एनी डिस्क्रिमिनेसन अनकट नेचरको ल चाहिँ हामी सबैले नै मानिसहरूले सबै चिजहरूले सबै रुखपातहरूले फलो गर्नुपर्छ आज एउटा फुल राम्रो छ भोलिको दिनमा ओइलेर जान्छ आज हाम्रो जिउ राम्रो छ भोलिको दिन हामी पनि के बिमार भएर जान्छ मरेर जान्छ हाम्रो सुन्दरता प्रकृतिको यो सबै छ एक दिन के भएर जान्छ हराएर जान्छ सो वाट इज पर्मनेन्ट यु नो वाट इज पर्मनेन्ट Change is only the permanent thing. Ironically, यस्तो रहेछ चेन्ज खालि चाहिँ एउटा जुन चाहिँ कुरा हो जो चाहिँ के छ पर्मनेन्ट कुरा छ अनि त्यो भएरै जान्छ सो इन दिस क्वाट्रन द पोएट इज ट्राइङ टु हाइलाइट द इम्पर्मनेन्स अफ ब्युटी द फ्लो अर द मिस्टेक अफ सन ओके एन्ड अल्सो द इम्पोर्टेन्स अफ or the power of nature prakriti ko euta power pani bhandecha author le impermanence of beauty pani bhandaicha and at the same time hamro sun okay sun ko pani ke gardaicha flaw dekhaudaicha beauty ko flaw dekhauna chahandaicha next now in the third quatrain he says but thy eternal summer shall not fade nor lose possession of that fair thou owest nor shall death brag thou wanderest in his shade when in eternal lines to time thou growest but thy but pagadi ko dui ta quatrain ma ke bhanyo sun ko hamile flaws bujhyo impermanence of beauty ओके अनि नेचर को पावर बुझ्यो प्रब्लम्स थे नि त अलिकति प्रब्लमहरु पोएट को प्रब्लम बुझे है तर यहाँ सडनली देयर इज अ चेन्ज इन इमोशन शिफ्ट इन इमोशन कसरी कसरी थाहा पायो बट अघि मैले भनेको थिए आई हैड अलरेडी एक्सप्लेन यू इन प्रीवियस स्लाइड्स वोल्टामा के हुँदो रहेछ सडन शिफ्ट अफ इमोसन ट्विस्ट हुँदो रहेछ अनि त्यहाँनिर नयाँ इमोसनले हाम्रो के गर्दैछ यहाँनिर ल्यान्ड गर्दैछ ओके यु विल कम टु नो अबाउट अनदर इमोसन अफ पोएट बट हुँदैछ दाई दाई भनेको यु योर योर इटर्नल समर स्याल नट फेड इटर्नल भन्नाले के बुझिन्छ पर्मानेन्ट समर समर हियर इज रेफरिङ टु द ब्युटी अफ द बिलभेड अब त्यो सुन्दरता को प्रेमिकाको सुन्दरता चाहिँ यहाँ चाहिँ अथरले चाहिँ इटर्नल समर भनेर चाहिँ के गर्न खोज्दैछ तुलना गरिरहेको छ भनिरहेको छ ओके स्याल नट फेड तर तिम्रो सुन्दरता चाहिँ तिम्रो पर्मानेन्ट यो ब्युटी चाहिँ के हुँदैन फेड हुँदैन फेड भनेको के हो रिड्युस हुँदैन भनेर भन्दैछ हाउ लेट्स सी नोर लुज पोजेसन अफ द्याट फेयर दाउ ओवेस्ट दाउ भनेको योर यु ओके ओवेस्ट भनेको इन ओल्ड शेक्सपियरियन टाइम्स दे युज टु युज द वर्ड ओवेस्ट द्याट मिन्स अहिलेको टाइममा ओन ओके सो द अथर इज ट्राइङ टु टेल यु टेल द बिलभेड द्याट द ब्युटी द्याट यु पोजेस ओर द्याट यु ओन विल नट फेड इन द स्यान्ड्स अफ टाइम इट इज गोइङ टु स्टे एन्ड आई विल इमोर्टलाइज इट इमोर्टलाइज भनेको अमर राख्ने छु बट हाउ लेट्स सी हाउ नर स्याल डेथ ब्राग thou wanderest in his shade and this now I have highlighted the two words like death brag and his yaha ke bujhinchha yaha kun chai technique use gareko rhecha personification he has used the figure of speech you know personification the poet has personified death as a man okay यहाँ चाहिँ पोएटले चाहिँ हाम्रो मृत्युलाई चाहिँ मान्छेको रूप दिएर चाहिँ के भनेको छ इभन मृत्युले धरी के गर्न सक्दैन घमण्ड गर्न सक्दैन कि तिम्रो सुन्दरता लग्यो भनेर के गर्न सक्दैन घमण्ड गर्न सक्दैन भन्दैछ रिमेम्बर वान थिङ ऑल अफ अस आर अन्डर द सेड अफ डेथ ओके बट हियर द अथर इज ट्राइङ टु टेल यु ओर द पोएट इज ट्राइङ टु टेल यु द्याट इभन मृत्यु इभन डेथ क्यान नट यु नो बोस्ट ब्र्याग भनेको बोस्ट घमण्ड गर्न सक्दैन फर स्टिलिङ फर ह्याभिङ स्टोलन अर फर स्टिलिङ द ब्युटी अफ द अफ हिज बिलभेड इभन मृत्युले धरि के गर्न सक्दैन तिम्रो सुन्दरता लान सक्दैन भनेर चाहिँ के भन्दैछ यहाँ कविले भन्दैछ वेन इन इटर्नल लाइन्स टु टाइम दाउ ग्रोवेस वेन इन इटर्नल लाइन्स इटर्नल भनेको पर्मनेन्ट पर्मनेन्ट लाइन्स टु टाइम दाउ ग्रोवेस भन्दाखेरि चाहिँ I will mention about the beauty or I have already mentioned about the beauty of your beauty in the lines in my poem mero kavita ma maile chai timro already sundarta ko varnan garisayeko chu ani yo kavita chai ke hunecha sadai amar bhayera janecha ani tesari nai timro sundarta chai ke huncha eta uta prachar bhayera janecha ani amar rahanecha bhanera chai ke bhanecha yaha chai kavi le chai sabai lai prastut garna chahancha o bhanna chahancha okay so in this way what he is trying to say is that the poet is or the poet will preserve will immortalize the beauty of his beloved in his works in his lines in this poem so we reading this poem itself is a testimony of the fact that the Shakespeare's or the poet's you know beloved's beauty is still alive okay next so the last you know two the last couplet or the two lines gives you the solution and what is the solution? So long as men can breathe or eyes can see, so long lives this, and this lives life to thee. So what the, you know, a poet is trying to say, that as long as man can see or breathe, or as long as men will read poetry, till then the beauty of his beloved will be alive. So in that way he would immortalize the beauty of his beloved. So this here means reading of the poem. Okay. सो यहाँ के भन्न चाहन्छ भने चाहिँ जबसम्म मान्छेले सास फेर्छ है, जबसम्म मनुष्य यो संसारमा जीवित रहन्छ अनि जबसम्म उनीहरूले के गर्छ कविता पढ्छ, त्यति बेलासम्म चाहिँ के हुन्छ उसको प्रेमिकाको कविको प्रेमिकाको सुन्दरता चाहिँ के भएर जान्छ, अमर भएर जान्छ, अनि त्यो चाहिँ एकदमै के छ अमूल्य छ है। जसरी नै पृथ्वी, जसरी नै सूर्य एउटा पृथ्वीको एउटा अङ्ग हो, त्यसरी नै के हुन्छ यहाँ चाहिँ यो कविको प्रेमिकाको सुन्दरता चाहिँ एकदमै ठुलो एउटा एकदमै अमूल्य अङ्ग हो, अनि त्यसैले चाहिँ उहाँले चाहिँ अमर गर्न चाहन्छ। अनि अमर चाहिँ उसले कसरी गराउने रहेछ यहाँ कवितामा उसको लेखेर, यु नो, डिस्क्रिप्सन्स दिएर। But you know the ironically another thing is, another important fact you should remember is, yeah, entire poem ma timile euta pani description dekhyau, like the premika ko or the beloved's description, he has not mentioned the beauty of his beloved, he has just compared the beauty of beloved to that of the beauty of the sun. Okay, haina yani ra ke gareko cha tulna khali gareko cha सूर्यको सुन्दरता, सरी, द बिलभेडको प्रेमिकाको, यु नो, सुन्दरता चाहिँ केसँग तुलना गरेको छ, सूर्यको सुन्दरतासँग तुलना गरेको छ, तर वर्णन त गरेको छैन नि त। सो द्याट इज वाट, द्याट इज आइरनी, द टेक्निक विच हि हेज एम्प्लोइड, विच द पोएट हेज एम्प्लोइड इन दिस पोयम इज द्याट अफ आइरनी। आइरनी चाहिँ एउटा टेक्निक हो जहाँ चाहिँ यहाँ विलियम सेक्सपियरले द पोएटले युज गरिरहेको छ। So what is the theme of this sonnet? The important theme is immortal love. Immortal bhaneko amar. He talks about his love for his beloved and also the beauty he's preserved, his the beauty of his beloved in this sonnet. Okay, and next is eternity of art. Second jo likhe bhanna chahinchha, importance of art. Art is one such thing that will not diminish or get destroyed over the period of time. It is going to stay forever, just like this piece of work, this piece of sonnet that which we are reading right now, and the generations will read. So you can imagine the importance of art. So here at the end he compares, or he says that the beauty of his beloved, the poet's beloved, will be immortalized in his work of art, that is poem. So in this way, you know, he ends the poem. So I would like you to tell you one important thing, ki if you want to excel or improve in English, you have to improve on four important aspects. Now why am I emphasizing on these four important aspects? Because poem is one such genre where you have to improve your reading skills. And if you want to develop English or develop skills in English subject, you have to develop these four aspects. And these four aspects are L, S, R, W. L is what? Listening. Sunnu parcha hamile ramro prakarle. Some say my pronunciation is not good, my speaking skill is not good, I cannot write properly. You know why? Because I don't think you're focused more on listening. You have to listen clearly. If you want to improve, listen to the speeches of good speaker. When you are here at home, as all of you are locked down, right, at your home, what you can do is sit aside and listen to some of the speeches, okay, given by some of the best orators or speakers. Close your eyes. If you don't understand the context or content, it's okay. Just close your eyes and listen to it. You will get a clarity of expression. S, Speaking is another important factor for you all to develop for a clarity of expression. And how will you develop speaking? By listening. R, reading. Reading is very important. Reading a poem is very important. Reading of any piece of material is very important in a correct way. So go and read books. Sit at home and read books, good books. In that way you will enhance your speaking skills, at the same time writing skills. RW, writing skills. See, most of the students have complained saying that my answers are not good because I am not able to express properly or clearly. Why you are not able to express properly? Because I think you have to read a lot. You have to develop a reading habit. You have to read the clarity. You have to have a clarity of expression, and you have to see the kinds of expressions that the others have given or the writers have written. So if you focus more on LSRW, you collaboratively improve on your English subject. Okay, it is not just about listening to stories or the narrations. It's about improving these four skills or four important aspects, LSRW. In that way you will come up with a good result. Okay, so moving on to the next. So these are the sample questions. Okay, the first one is a multiple question. Number one, but thy eternal summer shall not fade. Here thy refers to Shakespeare's friend. Next, his gold complexion dimmed. Here his refers to the sun, the sky, poet's friend, or poet himself. It's poet's friend. Next is a short question and answer. What kind of a poem is Shall I Compare Thee to a Summer's Day? It is a sonnet, a Shakespearean sonnet. What shall death not brag about in Shakespeare's poem? Okay, death shall not brag about stealing the beauty of the poet's beloved. Okay, next, long question and answer. Here's a dialogue given. But thy eternal summer shall not fade. Who is being referred to as thy? The poet's beloved. What is meant by eternal summer? Eternal summer here means the beauty of his beloved. Why shall not thy eternal summer fade? Because it is going to immortalize, or it is going to stay there forever as long as human beings exist. The last two couplets, okay, as long as human beings exist and as long as people continue to read poetry, what happens? His beauty, the poet's beloved's beauty, will be alive. Okay, now the second question is, what do the rough winds do? The rough winds blew away all the buds and shoots of the plant and apparently destroyed the beauty of the summer season. What does the poet mean by summer's lease? Here the poet is trying to say that the nature has given us summer season in contract, in for a short period of time, not literally contract, but for a short period of time. Okay, and next, how is the friend's beauty superior to that of a summer's day? Because how is the poet's, you know, beauty superior to that of summer's beauty? Here what happens? Summer's beauty or summer season is temporary, whereas here the poet's beloved's beauty is permanent. How? Because he has already inscribed in his work of art. Okay, so, and this is the link of a summary which I have taken it from internet and put it here for a detailed reference. Okay, and you take the link, you download it, and you use it for your future, you know, reference. And I have already placed it in the, you know, description. I've given it in the description box for your future reference. And yes, if you have any problem, you can leave a message in the comment box, and you know, I'm happy to help you all to clear your doubts and queries. So in this way, I would like to end my lesson for today. Thank you so much.